Earth. From the book of Genesis, it says, God created the heaven and the earth. Ever since, mankind was given the power of choice to have full faith in God and to follow His commandments. But something happened. They lacked faith in God, and sin entered this planet.
Upper deck of the Cypress structure, that is the section of highway that connects the Bay Bridge to the Nimitz Highway 880. It just seemed to collapse.
Fellow citizens, at this hour, American and coalition forces.
The networks, you hear, what did we learn? The media likes to say no more Vietnams.
Everything that is happening now points to that. It points to Jesus coming soon. And I know that not everybody believes that, but that's what I believe. I believe that Jesus is coming very, very soon, and it's told in the Bible. And it's proven through prophecy, and all of those prophecies are being fulfilled right now.
What is faith? I think we've heard the famous parable that Christ gave once. He said that if your faith is as a mustard seed, that you could move mountains.
The film 2012 is apparently scaring people who actually think the world may end soon.
In the year 2012, many wondered if the world is coming to an end. The Mayans' calendar ended, and the world witnessed numerous disasters around the world. While some prepared for the world to end, a group of young people gathered in Riverside, California, to test their faith in God.
They named this trip a faith trip. Yes, all our journey with you is a faith trip. We have not seen you, Lord, but through our relationship and your guidance, we know that you are there. As they live, watch care over them, dear Lord, as they travel from here to Seattle and as they go from door to door, Lord, speak through it.
I want to make a special appeal. The Lord has placed upon your heart to enter into ministry. I will challenge you to do it.
Yes.
I will challenge you. We need, the Bible says, the harvest is ripe, but the laborers are few.
Bye!
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 Bye! 1, 2, 3!
Faith should be fire!
My name is Felicia Tonga, and I am from the Hawthorne Seventh-day Adventist Church. I go to La Sierra University, and the way I got involved with Faith Trip, my brother did Faith Trip with Weimar last year, and he called me up at the end of October, and he said, "Hey, sis, what do you think about starting a Faith Trip?" And I told him, "No way," because I know that it's hard work and that it's a special calling. And so I had to know that this was exactly what God wanted us to do before we could actually move on it.
My name is Gavaka Ahoya. People just call me Vaka for short. And I am 22 years old, and I am from LA. Before Faith Trip, I was just an ordinary person.
My name is Louisa Bongo. I am from Sacramento, California. I go to the All Nations SDA Church. My youth leader, she was telling me about the trip, and you know, just hearing about it from her, I was like really interested. You know, it's something I'd be really willing to do, and you know, I think it'd be a lot learning experience.
So each city we stopped by, we started off one tank of gas, just going by faith. Every city we had books, and whatever donations we get off these books, those were our gas, our food, and the money for places we stayed in.
Faith is defined by the author of Hebrews as confidence of things hoped for,
and assurance of things not seen. That simply means to me personally that in our faith walk, we hope and claim that in the name of Jesus, He and He alone will fulfill not just some, but our every need.
When the faith trip originally started in 2009, I was one of the students who attended a faith trip from Weimar, California to Houston, Texas. We did something called colporting.
We're behind schedule. Things didn't go out as planned, but I'm glad that we're at least we're out here and we're moving. Right now we're making our way to Bakersfield, which is our first territory. So what we're doing right now is everybody's preparing, basically. Because right when we touch down at Bakersfield, we'll all be out there.
Okay, well, I mean, like, the whole point of this is actually, you know, to spread God's message. God has commanded us actually to do this through the spirit of prophecy. It's a divine work. You know, these are little witnesses, silent witnesses, that we are doing because we're going to people not to preach, but to give them literature to leave in the home. And, you know, we don't know whether that person's going to read it.
Right now, I'm kind of nervous. Still trying to get down this canvas. Because this is our main focus, is knowing what to say, how to say it.
Well, my name is Lesielli Hemuli, and I am 22 years old.
All right, level one to team. We are now 15 minutes to destination in our territory. And right now, I'd like to take time to share with you something from the spirit of prophecy from Colporter Ministry from chapter 18.
We are to be sincere, earnest Christians, doing faithfully the duties placed in our hands is not dependent upon our seeming success, but upon the spirit in which our work is done. As canvassers or evangelists, you may not have had the success you prayed for, but remember that you do not know and cannot measure the results of faithful effort.
Dearly Father, we thank you for everything you've done. We thank you for how far you brought us here. Lord, you didn't just bring us out here for nothing. We know there has to be something out there. There's someone out there who just wants to hear something about you. And while we're out here, we ask that you may bless us both. Just help us to reflect your character, only you. Forget about all the numbers.
So, resources that we started with was very little. We all started off with a full tank of gas, you know, that's it. You know, I didn't have no money. You know, if we did, only had like, what, 20 bucks or like 40 bucks, you know, and so we started off with basically nothing.
What kind of faith or how much faith? What does faith require? We know that the faith chapter in Hebrew says that faith is the substance of things not seen, hoped for. A faith trip was meant to inspire those who don't take a step out in faith. Faith trip was meant to inspire those who might be sitting on their hands and the Holy Spirit is wooing them.
So right now we just exited off of Main Avenue. And we are about to hit our first territory.
My name is Steven and I'm on a faith trip from LA all the way to Washington, Seattle.
And it's even wonderful. This right here is a book used for cooking. It has recipes that are like 30 minutes, that takes you only 30 minutes. It tastes wonderful and it's all natural. It's proven to help people reverse diabetes and all these different things simply because it's a healthy diet. This is for children.
I don't want to waste your time.
Okay.
So I was thinking to myself, if we have to leave Bakersfield and drive straight to Stockton, we need to make enough to fill both vans and the media car to get to Stockton. How are we going to do that? All right, guys.
Hopefully the next person I'll see some kind of door that I can wedge myself into and hopefully get something out. It's more about spiritual than selling.
Hello, sir.
How
you doing? My name is Steven, and I'm with a faith trip. And basically, we're traveling from LA all the way to Washington, and we're trying to raise some money.
I actually have peace in my own life. It's completely amazing. I've read this book personally for about lots of times.
So what's the reason you guys going up there?
We're going to go up there to do outreach and to help the community up in Washington, Seattle. We've been traveling all the way. We've been traveling, of course.
How's that?
Thank you so very much, sir. Thank you so much.
My name is Felicia, and I'm on a faith trip with some students. And basically what we're doing is we're working our way up to Seattle, and we're just leaving these books on a donation basis. And this is a cool book. I see that you're eating, so you probably enjoy food. And it has a lot of really good gourmet recipes. And the good thing about this book is it actually, it's good for the body. It heals the body. And so if you have any health problems or anything like that, this is a good book to turn to. No, that's okay. Well, I see that you have children here. And so this is a really good book for kids, and it's a cheaper donation price. And basically, it's called Storytime.
How you doing, sir? My name is Steven, and we're doing a faith, and I'm with a faith trip. And basically, we're traveling from LA all the way to Washington, Seattle. And we're offering... In a little fan in your room?
Yeah.
Okay, what time would you think to come back at?
Tomorrow.
We can't come back tomorrow.
Because I'm like...
Oh, okay. Well, if you want, then I can just show you. And you don't have to hold it. Well, this basically is a book about the great controversy. It talks about the time all the way till the end. But it talks about these people called the Waldensians. And the Waldensians were people who were persecuted for their faith during the Roman Empire time. And how they fought through it, how they hid in caves, and how God helped them and all that kind of stuff. It talks about how the Bible relates to the future.
We just started, and we're getting books out and homes. And this turn right here. He's probably looking through the window, but this house just got a conflicto. GC Spanish. Praise God. Praise God.
I went to my first door and I got a gourmet out. And I think that's amazing. That's so weird because we just started and this is my third house. And we got our second book out. Praise the Lord.
It was actually our first night in Bakersfield. I was driving down the street and I realized that there's cops flying by, but I didn't know they were there for us. And then out of nowhere, as I stopped there, the cops, I seen lights from the back, and then I seen like two other cars come from the side, and then another car in front of us, maybe five cop cars. And you know, we're just poor students. They're like freaking out and they didn't know what to do. And so I was just like telling everyone, stand by for pickup. And so all the students were coming to our car. And as they made their way to our car, we were like surrounded by cops, cars. We couldn't get out. Our faith trip, as of now, you know, we have no money. We came with one tank of gas, three cars, vehicles. Literally on faith, you know, if we look back at our lives, you know, just even yesterday, how much we've changed since last night. Or even last year, what were we doing, you know, a year ago?
Cold Porter work was designed to reach those who won't believe it without seeing it first, right? Some people are skeptics of the Bible. They're very skeptical when they hear scripture. They're skeptical when they hear things about faith. But what's amazing is this, the Bible doesn't just have amazing stories like David and his mighty men, amazing stories like the splitting of the Red Sea. The Bible doesn't just have stories like that. The Bible also has things like prophecy. Like, did you know that the Bible predicted the rise and fall of empires from Babylon, Medo-Persia, Greece, Rome? It even prophesied the United States of America.
I woke up, but it wasn't my choice. It was from the noise that everybody else is making in the room. All the guys, I don't know how they managed to wake up this early, but still kind of tired, but everybody's in this nice, happy little mood, so it's might as well, right?
Amen!
But yeah, we're about to have breakfast right now.
My name is Christy, and I'm here on the Faith Trip 2012, inspired
And I actually joined Faith Trip through my friend Senny. I heard she was gonna come and join the Faith Trip, and I was like, oh my gosh, that's so cool, it's so awesome. And I was like, oh, but should I go, should I not go? And then one time in my devotional, like, I was reading, and I'll just read this. This is from PM 280. And may the Lord move upon many of our young people to enter his service as evangelistic canvassers. Our time for work is short. The Lord calls for workers just now. So, you know, I just read that and I was like, oh, answer to prayer. God wants me to go. So I signed up and the Lord has been blessing since.
We have the whole team on a strict vegan diet. I know some of our canvassers are not vegetarian, and I know some of them definitely were tired of not eating meat. I think that there was definitely some hunger pains that they were feeling.
To print out territory for Stockton, and somebody's having some difficulties right now, but yeah, so that we can pray. As soon as we touch down in Stockton, we actually have to pick up a map because we don't have one.
Right now we're getting ready to go to Stockton. And we're just packing everything up, cleaning up this house.
Just like the trash, put the trash away.
Well, we just finished preparing lunches, and we're just cleaning up a bit.
Let's go ahead and pray before we leave.
We thank you once again for the opportunity of life. And we thank you for the opportunity of giving us a way to trust in you and to have faith. You promised to us in the Bible that you can do all things through Jesus who can strengthen us. Lord, I pray that this group not only continue on, stay close to you, but help them to find what they seek for and prepare their soul.
He just offered to fill our vans with gas, which is a good thing because we were about to use all of our money on gas. So that is good, and we're looking into buying chains because it's going to be snowing further up north, so that gives us some money to go buy some chains for our vans. So thank you, praise the Lord.
You know, these books help reduce and get rid of diabetes.
Yeah, man. For your kind donation.
Cool.
And then right here, this is not a piece, it's like a...
I have children, that's why I support any youth come by and make you feel good.
Canvas them, and then you're praying, and then you observe what they're doing, you know. And if you see that they have an interest in a book, like the Peace Above the Storm, you're like, oh, we actually have this one, Man of Peace, you know. This is our peace set. It talks about, you know, the falsified self as a man of change, of course, of history. California, so we're heading up north, so that's kind of the weather that we're going to expect as we head up north, is a lot of rain, perhaps some snow, it's going to be really, really cold.
Right now we are facing some hardcore Northern California weather. It's pretty slippery and wet out here. We cannot see much in front of us. But we are going to pray that the Lord will still bless and that we may get books out. And we're just gonna pray for God's wisdom that he may guide us, know what to do in different places. So this is Faith Trip Inspired 2012, Los Angeles to Seattle, Washington.
the Lord just blessed. So, you know, God definitely blessed. The beautiful thing is that at the end of the night, the moon was shining. Nothing, no rain, no, not a drop of rain, not a sprinkle. So God definitely heard our prayer, from the rain to the buckle to Kafana. He offered to fill up all of our gas tanks, two vans and one car. And he was in, he got books as well. He got five books. Just amazing, just because God knew what was gonna happen.
I was like, did you think I was going to do anything?
Yeah.
She was like, she said she wouldn't have been surprised. I was like, no, I'm not one of those people.
Yeah, yeah. No, that's good. That's good.
Okay, Priest of the Storm offers you freedom from worry, guilt, and fear. It has short, inspiring stories, beautiful nature pictures. It's very uplifting. Seven Secrets is an awesome cookbook. I love to cook out of this book. It's delicious, you know. You know, this is a really good recipe right here. And I actually just made these cookies last week, and they were really good.
It's slow. It's slow this morning. People was not home, and if they are, you know, they're not very, you know, accepting or welcoming, you know. So it's going slow.
Today is day two. We're here in Stockton. It's not as easy as it was yesterday. Yesterday, I just got to basically get out there and test the waters, basically. So now I had newer expectations for today, and it didn't turn out as well as I thought it was. Yesterday was fun. Now, I don't know, I'm just keeping everything in prayer, trying to stay positive, because it's very discouraging.
First house didn't go so well. The second one, it was a blessing. I got an HD in the home. And the man literally offered me a handful of change, which was awesome.
I'm just trying to scout out some territories because it seems like a lot of people are not home. I don't know why. And you know, some books are not getting out. We just got our first book out, so praise the Lord. And so I'm just cruising around the streets just to see if I can find some territory where people are home. We're trying to look for lots of cars, you know, if we see people outside, even though it's cold.
I'm meeting a lot of nice people though, and they just can't give.
I just thought it was something really scary, you know. I know I don't like to be rejected, and no human likes to be rejected, have a door slammed in your face.
How you doing, man? Oh, my name is not gonna wear hats on the fake trip instead of junk food and cheese. Oh, that's more information.
That's what happens.
You get slammed on.
Man, I got slammed on so many times today.
There's nothing you can do about it, though. Gotta do it, man.
Hi, my name is Christy, and we're on a faith trip. And instead of junk food and trinkets, we have something much more lasting. And I'll let you take a quick lick.
I'm not interested.
Oh, well, for those not interested, because we're trying to raise some money for our faith trip.
I'm not interested.
All right, thank you.
I appreciate that, guys. Preaching about the Armageddon as well. I said I give towards our organization. I'm one of Jehovah's Witnesses.
Oh,
so,
that's awesome.
So I already do the door to door and all that stuff.
Then would you like the cookbook?
Nope, I'm fine. Thank you very much, sir, for your time.
Thank you, sir.
I appreciate it.
Biggest thing people need to see: behold what manner of love the Father has given unto us. So once they see that, they come under the spell of God, God's spell, the good news, and they want to respond. They are able to have victory in an area they never had before. They're able to clean up their life. They're able to have a happy wife. They're able to have everything go correctly according to God's plan. It doesn't mean they won't have persecution. It doesn't mean they won't have problems, but even those problems are used for good, because all things work together to good, the who are called by God, that are under His spell, the gospel. So we need to get out there with the books. We need to get out there in the homes. I would not be here today without literature evangelism, because someone gave my great-grandfather a book, changed his life, and it changed my dad's life and all these different people in my family, my great-great-grandfather, actually. So get out there, sell those books, because God's going to use them in a mighty way to spread His spell, the gospel, in a world that's under the devil's spell.
Frank, do not be discouraged, guys, because God has blessings ahead of us. So just do what you gotta do, and keep it up, guys.
The Lord has really been blessing, and he's just been doing amazing things out in the field that have just blown my mind and have really increased my faith. So I'm really grateful to God for just showing me His awesome power through this trip.
Oh yeah, and PTL Luisa for that gourmet. PTL, keep it up, team. Do not be discouraged. Keep it up. God is going to bless.
But no one in the United States or around the world enjoys a job where you have to go door to door. That's almost like a last resort kind of job. To do a work like this requires faith, right? You want to talk about a work that beats you up, eats you up, spits you out, and the next day you do it again? This is the kind of work that does it. I would definitely say it's probably some of the hardest work that anybody would encounter, to face rejection, possibly at every door.
I wanted to do something good, you know, before this year ended. And I know it would be a good experience to try something new. And this is new to me, knocking door to door.
It seems like no one has money. And this neighborhood is just, it's just finding the right people. That's the key. And I know there's a door somewhere down there where someone is waiting and wanting these books. So I just gotta keep going.
Man, it's tiring. It's a lot of walking, though. This is how you lose weight.
That's your first book, right?
Yeah, but
first book right here.
I know. Oh wait, can you call it in, please?
She was like, "All I have is a box of coins," and she literally had a box of coins. She came and she was like, "I have a bag I can dump it into. That'd be fine." I was like, "Yeah, that'd be fine." She dumped it in a bag and then.
Yeah. Go back and call it in.
Like right now?
Yeah, mobile one, back out.
Okay, call it in. Call it in.
Move. No.
Come on.
You have to.
Mobile one, can you channel up again? Sorry.
Come on, before I channel up. Go. Mobile one, back out. Salud. Go.
Mobile one, back out. Salud.
BTL Baka! That's what I'm talking about!
Because we have an advocate with the Father in heaven. And we just ask that your Holy Spirit would go before, touch the hearts, that we might get your word out and be a blessing to others. In Jesus' name we ask these things, amen.
Those are apartments. Oh, what are these looking like?
Look at that.
Oh, I see cars. I see cars, I see kids.
People always ask the question, what is the minimum I can do for Jesus or to get into heaven? And I don't think that that's the question that we should be asking. I think the question that we should ask is, what is the max that I can do for Jesus? Because that's what Jesus did for us. He did the max. He didn't just come here and just do the bare minimum. He did everything that he could do to save us.
Our job here on earth is to show the love of God everywhere we go. For the colporter, the issue is getting over your feelings. You just got rejected at this door, and it's time to move to the next door. But man, I've got this. I'm so upset. I'm so emotional right now. How can I go to the next door?
Yeah, and before we start to eat, I just want to, on behalf of our team, I just want to say thank you to Fohe and your family, your whole family from here to the back, for opening your houses to us so that we can have a place to stay and to eat. Honestly, you guys didn't have to do all of that, but man, praise the Lord. It's good to know that we have hot food waiting for us.
So can we ask how did you guys do today?
We set a goal for 40 books today, and we got over the amount of 40 books, and we got stopped by cops yesterday, and we got stopped by cops tonight. Wow. Stay-in's working, but,
that's the time.
But God has
me, was it you?
From 16 books in 2 hours last night to over 40 books
within
4 hours.
More
to come.
So, well, we got soup here.
Yeah, it makes us comfortable. There's food, there's water. Yo. Second order left, right here.
We're just thankful to have you guys stop by here with us and just share your guys' word with us and just a fellowship. It's always nice. And so I thank you guys for doing what you guys are doing and just stay strong.
I mean, Luisa, I don't want vegetable soup. She wants my raviolis. You want my pasta. Get Luisa some pasta. That's what she wants.
I am Julie Chung. I'm going to Canvas.
Yeah.
Because at the last minute, like, someone else called me up and they're like, hey, we have a ride for you, you can come with us. But then, so I was like kind of debating which one to go. Sarah told you guys I'll be coming.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, I'm here because I believe that God wants me to. Yeah.
Amen.
That God wants me to be here.
You're God's gonna use you. Amen. I'm so happy that you joined us. More cameras is better, so you're definitely gonna be best.
I just want to say that God has been such a blessing to us so far. We were staying at Talaheo and Fohe's house, and they were so hospitable towards us. And I think that was the hugest blessing of it all. And we just got to share our experiences with them, and we got to pray with them, and they got to pray for us, and it was a blessing. And so we left from Stockton, and the first place that we stopped at was Lodi. Lodi has a small little Adventist community that's behind an Adventist church. And we went there, we were canvassing around there. We got to meet really, really cool people. It was our warm-up before we actually hit the actual territory that we were gonna go to. And there we met Allie.
Allie over here.
Allie King.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wait. Yeah. Cause she's our
Allie King's your daughter?
Oh, is
no,
she?
She's not. No, she's not my daughter.
Oh.
Where's Allie?
She lives in 37 here. And I see her vans right there. So.
Allie.
That's the vans there.
This man just came over here. He's pointing us to a Bible worker that works here in this complex. So maybe we can talk to her and she can tell us where to go, you know, how people can donate. So
Allie King!
She canvassed last year.
Yeah.
So who's Allie King?
She's from Weimar. She canvassed. I want to meet her too. Can I come too?
I'm coming too.
Exactly. Ali was on Faith Trip last year, and she was also on the documentary from last year.
I hope she comes back with more than 60, because I want to get a 7 or 8 book set. I've been praying for a 7 or 8 book set for 2 years. And I think this might be the door. Oh my. I love her, my prayer. Oh my.
Mobile One Ali, final D2, HTL, Peace, ST, RH, Pop, and MFJ. That would be a dump bag.
Oh, Ali, BTL.
Oh, Ali King! Oh. She wasn't doing anything, and she immediately hopped on board, and she joined us, and she canvassed with us all night.
I'm excited to be able to join you guys. It's really cool to see the new faces of the Faith Trip 2012. And the GYC, even though I won't be there, but I'm excited. These people are really nice, so it's going good.
And everything that she made, she put it towards Faith Trip to help us get to Seattle. We were really, really blessed to have her on the team. We left from there, and we went and we hit a territory that was really, really sweet. And people immediately started calling in books. Julie, who had just joined us, she was calling in books along with Samu and Gavaka and all of them. And so God was definitely blessing at that first territory.
Julie, peace. Woo! This is good. God is good.
I'm feeling good. So, two books we just got here, Peace Above the Storm and Real Heroes, a children's book.
So I asked her if she liked to read, and she was like, yeah, I do. I like to read books that are like based on the Bible. And I was like, really? And, you know, showed her The Man of Peace, you know, explained that to her, and that got her hooked right away, and she was willing to buy it.
Luisa last night had a really cool experience along with Steven. They were invited into someone's house. The woman that they were with shared that she was, you know, just going through some really lonely times and she just wanted someone to listen to. And they got to pray for her. And she was so appreciative that she asked if she could pray for them as well. And that was an answer to prayer for Luisa, because she was feeling really, really discouraged. And she was asking God, if one of them could just pray for her, that would just make her day. And that happened at their last door. The woman was so inspired by what the team was doing that she took her checkbook out and she wrote another check. And that's how our night ended for canvassing.
This is day three on our Faith Trip. And we're here in Sacramento, Southside Sacramento. We're about to finish our lunch, and right now, it's about like 6 o'clock or close to 6. And we're having our lunch, which is late. So after this, we'll be going to our next territory, which is up at North Sacramento. And it's a safer place. So that would help us to work and finish off at 8:30.
And it says, respect paid to the proper treatment of the stomach will be rewarded in clearness of thought and strength of mind. And they did some research on mummies. Back then in the Egyptian days, and he found that the majority of them died from heart disease.
I'm almost to it. I mean, I've sold on a donation basis 7 books. 7 books. We're not done yet. So, God will bless, I'm sure.
Hope we get a lot of books out. It's kind of chilly out here. About like kind of cold.
Right. Right behind you.
All right, so we gonna...
You're the mind, you're the muscle.
No. I'm the mind, they the muscle.
You lead out, we will follow from a distance.
That's how they ate. And the Bible says that diseases that I placed upon the Egyptians upon you. You know, so he's telling you, if you listen to what I have to say, then none of these diseases will come upon you. You know, like I placed on the Egyptians. But in that case, we're gonna talk about digestion.
Everyone begins as a baby Christian. How do you know you're a baby Christian? You don't know how to walk with the Lord. But what you don't realize is, you know, the scripture says that he takes you with his right hand. And though it seems he may fall, he will not, because God holds him with his right hand. So for a baby Christian, when you do something like the Cole Porter work, And I began to pray different prayers. It went from, Lord, help me, to Lord, help them. Lord, what give me the words to say so that I can help them? What need can I meet for them today?
Luck I'll be there too.
So basically, right now what's happening, we're eating this peanut butter jelly sandwich right here. Yeah, you know, you see that. Anyways, not the healthiest thing, but it's what we got.
God has been blessing, just helping me look through Google Maps, and just checking out different neighborhoods, spotting out if there's cars, you know, the 1 to 4 territories, as well as the 5 to 9s, you know, up rich territories, poor territories. You know, God has been giving me that wisdom just to hop on Google and just checking it out and seeing, you know, what territories look like they're gonna be a blessing. And we're just praying that God will open doors and that people will actually open their hearts.
We got to Luisa's house pretty late last night, probably a little after 10. And there, Sio Nevea, along with Mafi Leo and some of the other guys were waiting for us, and they had some hot food waiting as well.
And I just did my top sheet, and I met my goal, plus one book. God will bless, I'm sure. So God really blessed, and I'm really happy about that.
I represent our church here in Sacramento, and Siana's family for his hospitality, except for you guys to spend a night here. Mm. And I think just take the food and leave the house tomorrow, okay?
You know, challenges and trials and tribulation, it is strength. Each and every day you face all those difficulties and challenges, that's how you build your character. That's how you build your faith in Christ. And that's how your faith will strengthen and have stand still in Jesus Christ. When you come back and you see all those things, it's awesome God that I believe and trust in you.
So they
got to
go to sleep.
But there was a point where...
It's 11 o'clock. So they have about 30 minutes to...
We have 30 minutes to shower.
Get ready, shower, brush your teeth, wash your face,
5 minutes.
Cut their hair, shave. And yeah, so they can hit the bed so we can hit the road tomorrow. We're going to Redding, California. It's going to snow.
Yeah, it's going to snow.
And this weather is all I have. So snow tomorrow for me, no good news.
So tomorrow might be his last day.
Father God, we thank you, Jesus, for dying on the cross for us. Take away our sins. Father, we pray that you continue their faith. Don't let Satan or allow Satan to do some harm and danger in the world for them. Father, we pray, be with them all the way to Seattle. Enjoy the excitement program that we prepare for this COIC Seattle.
On this road, these two disciples were discouraged. It was Sunday. Theoretically about 3 o'clock, and it was the third day since Christ had passed away. These two were walking the road to this town called Emmaus, and the Bible says they were walking and talking as if they were sad, and Christ draws near to them. Christ asked them a question. He said, why do you walk and talk like you're sad? What's going on? What's the matter here? And they turned around and they said, you haven't heard the things going on today? Jesus Christ of Nazareth was crucified. For the small town of Israel, this was a big deal. It says in Luke 24 that he began to expound to them the things of the scriptures. Beginning at Moses and the prophets, he went through the entire Bible. To them at that time was the Old Testament. And he began to unfold the things, revealing himself. If you read that story to the very end, what you discover is that their eyes were opened as Christ spoke and broke bread before them. They said to themselves, is this not the Christ that walked and talked with us on the way? And it says that their hearts were burning within them. In other words, Christ inspired them through literature, through his holy word, the things concerning himself.
Well, what I learned is,
when we're going door to door, even in the good times, we have to keep going. There's no time to just pause and just stop running. You have to keep on going. We didn't reach our goal of books, but then donations, our money just like are piling up, and we'll be able to pay everything off by this week. And so God's been very good. And so when I go back home, even in our like in our devotion times, we have to keep on.
Here in day four, fake trip, and right now we're packing the bags in here and the books in here so we can get on the road and get to territory. And as you can see, there's a lot of luggage here, and we're gonna canvas in the snow. That's the plan. Canvas in the snow. I got my snow jacket on, got my scarf, we're all ready to do this. We're heading to Redding, California, and we just got the news that it might be snowing, or it will be cold for sure. They say like 20 degrees, and in very slippery roads. And the girls are packing the food, our lunch,
have something to eat later on.
Praise the Lord for women, huh?
As you can see, as the days progress, we managed to find more and more stuff to put in the vans somehow. Yeah. But that's fine though.
No.
Because we're pros.
Yeah.
And we can fit in.
As the Apostle Paul tells us in the book of Philippians, chapter 3, I believe, verses 13 to 15, he says, folks in Philippi and to all people throughout the generations, I am still a work in progress. But there is one thing, he says, not two, not five, not 20. He says, but there is one thing I am intentional about, is that I forget my past and I reach forward to the prize that is prepared for me, and that is life eternal. And I believe if we are intentional about that, and again, in this faith walk, and keeping our trust and our focus on Christ, and to know that yes, even in our flesh, in times when we fall short, the Lord will see us through.
Yeah, there was like 8 miles of traffic, and it was quite slow. The ride is a little bit uncomfortable. We're heading towards Redding right now. Right now we're in Sacramento, and we're on our way to Redding. That's like about three hours away, 2.5 hours away, something like that. But we parked right here, and you know what's pretty cool about this place? I just looked, and the license plate says Faith on it. Now, it's kind of interesting because we're on the faith trip. And so for this to have faith on it is kind of like an assurance that what we're doing is actually the right thing. It's like a sign almost, if you get my gist.
I want to get out there already. And tired of waiting. Just want to get it over with. Get out there and do what we came here for, which is spread the word to those who need it most. And that's what I want to do right now.
We could really see God working. We could see God's hand in everything that we were doing. Even if cops were stopping us, or doors were being slammed in our faces, or people were just unwilling to help, He was definitely teaching our team patience.
We're about to hit our first territory around here in Redding. We just got here from Sacramento, and the plan is we're gonna have lunch first, so then we can hit the territory hard that we have planned, and we'll be working until 8:30, I believe. We all have a set goal that we're trying to reach, so we're all making sure that we all reach that goal, and that's the plan.
Like we're fixing cars.
It's not so good for
me. Right,
We got into Redding, California, and it was really, really cold. I think we all immediately realized that there was something different about this town. You hear about and you watch on TV how the economy is suffering, but to see it on the people's face, it was heartbreaking.
basically, it's hard to try to get into doors and stuff. I need to slow down and really concentrate on meeting the people's needs more than trying to just sell these books. And so I'm trying to figure out different ways, just observing the person, slowing down a bit more, and just taking the environment around, looking at the scenery, and trying to meet the needs more. So that's basically what I'm thinking about right now. So hopefully I'll figure it out soon.
Right now, I'm feeling rejected, but it's fine because I felt like that yesterday, and there was just one person that I talked to that just changed it all towards the end of the night. And if I have to do that all over again, meaning get rejected until the very last person, then that's fine. At least it'll make up for everything else beforehand. Take out Bible prophecy and explains it a little bit more in depth.
Yeah, I ain't got no dough right.
You got it?
If I had some, I would.
And everything is all based off the donation. Neighbors have been donating like based off of $10, but even if you don't have that, or you don't like to read.
Dude, I really don't have any money at all. I don't even have a job right now, dude. I'm up and I'm gonna find a job here soon.
I think we more so realized that donations were not at the top of our list that evening. Hope, prayer, just offering a little bit of light to a group of people that were searching for something better. I think that that was what Reading needed, or more so, that's what we needed.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful day, bless us with. We thank you for bringing me here to find Kurt. Lord, please bless him, Lord. Help him with his struggles that he has. Lord, help him to find a job, Lord. We ask that you may open doors for him, just so he can provide for his family, Lord. I ask you these things in Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thanks a lot, Kurt.
Thank you again. You guys have a good one.
God bless. God bless, sir.
Hey, you guys have a good Christmas.
Well, right now I'm feeling a bit okay. Within like the first 30 minutes, I already got to pray with someone who was really in need of help.
Do what we came here for, spread the word to those who need it most.
He's actually living off of unemployment right now. And I got to say a quick prayer with him. He was real open with it, came out, was willing to talk to me and so forth. And the most I could leave him with was a prayer, and that counts as well.
Another mission trip, but this is one that's so different from all the other ones that I went on. And I think what makes it so different is the fact that we're literally relying on God, and we're asking him to lead us to places so that we can meet people. And I think it's shown me how important it is to go out and to introduce them to the God that we know.
Right now, we had put on the chains, took us a while to get on, you know, never really driven in snow, and it's pretty snowy out here, and we're taking off until we realized the chains weren't still put on right.
I'm learning how to do this for the first time. I hope I'm doing it the right way, but it's all right.
And the boys had to come out and help us and fix our chains on our tires. So we're just hoping that the chains can get put on right.
It started snowing a lot, and I've never seen snow ever in my life until this time. And we all had to pull off, and everyone was required to put on chains. What should have taken like 10 minutes to do took us almost 2 hours to do. Why did it take 2 hours? Because we had three vehicles, two vans, and one car. And as soon as we thought everything was right and we'll drive off, one of the chains snapped and it was just like slapping the side of the vehicle. So we had to pull over and retie it. And we did this like multiple times and it was very frustrating.
We had stopped earlier to put on the chains and we still didn't put them on right. You know, we really haven't driven in this type of weather, and not much of us know anything about putting on chains on tires.
All right.
So we had stopped again to fix these chains.
We know how to put on tires.
Hopefully you put them on correctly this time, but as you can see, it's really snowing out here. It's crazy.
Well, the highlight of the faith trips so far, personally, is just seeing God moving in the team. People in our own team are starting to have a more strong relationship with the Lord.
Okay, so we just prayed maybe like 3 minutes ago. And as you can see now, the sun's coming out behind us. And it's such an answer to prayer. You can also pan to the front and see that the road is clear. Visibility is just awesome now. And we just want to praise God for all of His goodness, for all that He's done for us in answering our prayer, especially just lifting the rain, and now He lifted the snow for us too. We just want to glorify God.
As you can see, it's really, really snowing. It's coming down pretty hard. All right, this is the church that we are staying at. This is beautiful. This is Christmas weather.
Hi, my name is Steven Ledger. I'm from New York, and I got to Faith Trip because I just wanted to come, and I felt God was leading me towards it. Basically, you just have to keep walking and hope that the next person nearby would allow you to go into their home and have you sit down, or you can just knock on the door and say, hey, can I take a break and rest a little bit? That's usually what you can do, which ends up getting you books sold.
Yeah, well, that looks good.
Yeah, Grants Pass is population about 33,000.
I caught couch.
You can hang out in this section here, just, you know, do your thing.
Was that made by a chef?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, I know who did that.
Mark Anthony.
Yeah, there you go. He
right?
Church,
I would not recommend, especially with this kind of weather, to be out after dark too.
You would just go right now.
Like the weather's like this and it's dark.
Six. Yeah.
That's like a double
you know, no. Yeah,
double
like
no.
You're like, okay.
Like, who are you?
Yeah.
What are you? So you got then,
yeah.
50 minutes. Right.
Power.
Lord, we're going to be going canvassing. We ask that you would keep these precious books and truths dry so that people can see the value of these books in a presentable manner. And may you keep each one of us warm and keep us healthy. And may your Holy Spirit go and already prepare the hearts of those who we're going to be encountering. And may you give us many, many divine appointments by your grace. In Jesus' name we ask this.
And right now it's beautiful. It's snowing like crazy, but we're still gonna push on and canvass each door.
God bless you, bro.
Hi, my name is Julie and I'm from Sacramento. I've been learning that faith trip is not all by feeling, and no matter how much we get rejected, discouraged, even in the good times too, we have to keep on going because we have to remember what Jesus did for us.
We meet nice people over here.
Baby, basically we're traveling from LA all the way up to Seattle, and we've been going door to door, just leaving books like this.
Great book.
And I'll let you take the quick look.
We've been talking about the ends of times, love of Christ.
But you guys are doing a great job, and I see God really working. And next week we're going to work even harder. But so this is like a warm-up week, and so so I do want to just tell you guys quickly before we go to bed.
When a Christian is inspired by God, when they're moved by the cross of Jesus, when God is calling them to do something greater than they're doing, you probably find the summary of that in the Gospels, Matthew 28, where Christ gives his great commission. And he says, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Teaching them. To observe all things.
And whatsoever I have commanded you, Lord, I am with you always, even to the end of the earth. So Christ gave this commission because he didn't expect the work to end at you, but he expected the work to begin with you.
As the Spirit becomes real to you, you're commanded to go and inspire someone else, introduce them to Christ, so that He would become real to them. And for each person, it's supposed to be a beginning, a new beginning, a new beginning. This work was not meant to end, but it was meant to go even to the end of the earth.
You know, this is a country that was established for, of, and by the people. It was never supposed to become for, of, and by the government. And people were supposed to be free in every way. Freedom of speech, freedom of religion. All of these things are under enormous attack right now.
He says, you know what, is working on Sundays true freedom? And basically says, you know what, all of this hard work that people are doing on the weekends, on Sundays, is having a negative impact on their lives.
First, we've had some breaking news from the U.S. Supreme Court, which has said that same-sex couples have a constitutional right to marry. It was a 5-4 ruling, and the court said marriage is a fundamental right and same-sex couples could not be deprived of it.
ISIS keeps finding new ways to horrify. This time, 21 Coptic Christians from Egypt beheaded on a beach in Libya.
We're in complete agreement that we need to stop to fail.
But I don't understand. It is working like an insurance policy. Ordinary folks pay for homeowners insurance. Ordinary folks pay for car insurance. And these big financial institutions are getting cheaper borrowing to the tune of $83 billion in a single year.
As you watch this Faith Journey video, maybe sitting in your living room, you may be watching it from a classroom, you may be watching it on your laptop, iPad, whatever the case is, and you may be asking that very same question right now. How do I serve God? And personally, the how for me is found in Genesis chapter 22, when the Lord tested Abraham. And scripture says that when God tested Abraham, in chapter 22, verse 3, Abraham answered with three words, and he said, "Here I am." And scholars and historians tell us that in that old narrative, that Abraham had not heard from God in 17 years. That simply means that in a span of 17 years, God was silent in Father Abraham's life. Abraham didn't hear from God physically, but he continued to seek God in this faith journey. And remember, Abraham had the confidence and the faith in God, even when God was silent in his life.
That's something I really face, and that has helped me to really understand how important, you know, it is to spend time with God, and that we can't do this work on our own. It's truly impossible to rely on ourselves to be able to be successful and affect lives all at the same time. We can rely on self and still be successful, but internally we're dead. You guys ready for war? We're getting ready to go hiking up Mount GYC. Woohoo!
Can someone tell me real quick what our objective is? What's the objective of this work? It's to win souls. Is cold porter work easy?
No.
It's not. Have you found it to be difficult? You have, right? We discussed in a worship talk that you would be foolish to love this work. You would be foolish to love Bible work. And it's not because we don't like to do it, but because if the burden of souls is not stronger than going out to the field, then what are you out there for? When Jesus comes again, there will be no more co-porter. When Jesus comes again, there will be no more Bible. This is the tactic that we've chosen to use in order to reach people here in Seattle.
I would definitely encourage others to travel in faith because, it's through faith that we grow. You know, as it says in the book of James, that, you know, faith without work is dead. We can easily say yes, you know, we can pray for something, but if we are not taking that initiative to act upon it, then there is no blessing. You know, I can pray, but I have to do my part. You know, it's just like filling out for a job. I can pray to get a job, but if I have not filled out the application that they may know that I want the job, then how can I get an answer? So it's the same thing as faith. You know, I would encourage, you know, anyone, you know, faith trip, as a friend told me, it's a lifetime. And if anybody would have the opportunity to, you know, step out of the comfort zone and to really just rely on God, I would definitely encourage them to take that challenge, because it'll only make them stronger and it'll only help them to grow in Christ.
GYC. Woo-hoo! Finally, yeah! Finally we made it. We've gone a long way with Julie. And we're finally headed over there. They don't have to canvas no more. I know they miss it though.
Don't lie.
But now we're headed to the hotel to get everything ready and get everything ready for GYC.
Finally made it after 2 weeks. We're about to register.
City off the nation's faith trip 2012.
All off the donation.
Friends, we're coming to you live from Seattle, Washington. We're actually today. We had just a little bit of sunshine and no rain. But we're coming here to you from GYC. You may have heard of GYC before, but this is the 2012 GYC convention. We always enjoy this event very much. It's such an inspiration to us personally. But you know, I also want to mention too that 3ABN has been so privileged and so blessed to have a part and be a partnership with GYC, I believe, over the past, what, eight or nine years, I think. So what a blessing to be here, and we want to welcome you, too, to GYC.
As you can see behind us, the young people are streaming in. There's almost 4,000, the last count that I heard, that are registered from 49 states and 43 countries all over the world. GYC stands for Generation of Youth for Christ, and it's an organization, a movement, really, that are dedicated to sharing the gospel message in this generation with the world.
Just waiting to get in line, as you can see. This is like the whole world, only one third of the world.
And then we're just kind of all scattered everywhere. Everyone went to different seminars.
Elisha prayed, "Lord, I pray, open his eyes that he may see." Then the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw, and behold, the mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire. I encourage you to pray this prayer and to go out there and to fight for souls. You know, and you don't have to canvas. You know, when you go to a grocery store, pass out glow tracts, you know, or something. Do your part and to hasten Christ's coming. Lord, I'm going to stand on your promises, and I want to see what you can do in my life, you know. And I promise you from experience, God will change your life, and he will do it, because God's promises are sure, and they will never fail. Please pray this prayer and stay devoted to the Lord every single morning and every single day. The devil would attack, but it wasn't really, you know, it wasn't really attacking, you know. So I prayed to the Lord, you know, like, show me the great controversy. So he answered my prayer and he sent me a canvas. And knocking on doors, oh, believe me, you will see it. You know, you will see the great controversy at hand. You know, people will scream at you, they'll curse you, you know, they'll tell you to get out of my house. You know, they like throw stuff at you. I had this little kid spraying me with the water hose, man. Man, it was crazy. Like, I was trying to catch the mom, and he was just spraying us, you know? And the mom was like, stop, you know, like, stop. And then, like, she'll turn it off, and the kid will run back and turn it back on, like, spray it. I was like, man, I'm gonna slap you right now. You know, like, about to get to the bus right now and go to outreach. It's feeling kind of cold, but God is good.
Keep moving and sit down, please.
We're expecting that you're going to do great things through us. So we pray that you could just fill us with the Holy Spirit, help set up divine appointments so that we can share you with others, Lord. And so we just pray that you give us boldness today and that we could help to finish your work, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
We're about to canvas with the whole GYC. As you can see over here on my left, everyone's already hitting all the houses. And me and Michael are about to do this whole street going down this way, if you can see over here. So God is definitely blessing, and keep us in your prayer.
We'll catch you tomorrow. See you in the morning.
After witnessing the Faith Trip team reaching GYC in Seattle, the thought that came to mind was the risk that you take in this type of journey. It's similar to a base jumper jumping off a mountain with a wingsuit on. The risk can be very high and rewards only those who believe. As we begin a new year traveling, the message that this team delivered and the books they distribute are becoming a reality.
Whether you're Christian or you're not Christian, people know that something's happening. There are things happening that are beyond our control, whether it's with the economy or with the government, or things are taking place. In Matthew, Jesus says that there will be wars and rumors of wars, and there will be famines and pestilences and all of these things happening. And when you see these things happen, know that my coming is near.
With the New Mexico Supreme Court ruling that the Christians had to shoot the wedding or pay thousands of dollars in fines.
Alliance Defending Freedom disagrees, saying, again quoting here, should the government force an African-American photographer to take pictures of a KKK rally? A government that can force anyone to promote messages against his or her will is a government out of control.
I really learned about the power of prayer. We didn't have any cell phones on us. There was nothing. It was just me and my bag of books. And I had nothing to do but to pray.
Just to get a book, just so they can hear about you, especially to those who never had it.
And it's sad because it took for me to have nothing. It took for me to not have a cell phone. It took for me to not have a friend or a family member beside me. And then I noticed when you have nothing, you know that you have God.
The Gospel of Luke, chapter 19, verse 10, where I believe this is where God's mission statement is found. He says that the Son of Man came to seek and to save that which was lost.
By beholding, we are changed from glory to glory. And as we're changed, we become lights in the world. And people also say, what happened? What happened in your life? I want that in my life. That's what he wants from the believer. And you know what? as he gets that from the believer. Not something you can manufacture. It's something he already has manufactured.
Now in 2013, and may we just start this year a new creature, Lord. Father, you promised that you won't remember this, Lord, and we thank you in Jesus Christ's name.
Amen.
All right, so people want to hear, just so you know, we had a resolution that we put in here all of the things that was keeping us from getting to know God better, right? So it's all in here. Put rocks in here, you know, and just get so into it again. Already? No more. Hey guys, no more.
Okay, sing.
I got close off this section. You're welcome to go.
That we have to say goodbye in this life, but what we do know that there is a home, that there is no goodbyes. There's always we be together, and above all of this, we will be together with Jesus as our Lord and Savior.
Maranatha, Jesus is coming.